So in the last section, we saw that our new algorithm, based off of the leaderboard and cut method, worked well on a spectrum that was close to the correct theoretical spectrum. But once we had 25% false and missing masses, it didn't reconstruct the correct tyrosidine B1 peptide. I want to add some more bad news to that in this section, which is that these NRPs, these non-ribosomal peptides, including tyrosidine B1, they in practice will contain more non-standard amino acids that are outside of the standard genetic code. And this is because they're outside of the central dogma. So for example, here is a relative of tyrosidine B1 called tyrosidine B, and it's very similar to tyrosidine B1, except you'll notice that in this position it has an amino acid called ornithine. And this is a non-standard one. And so to deal with these non-standard amino acids, because there are so many of them, what bioinformaticians assume sometimes, and what we'll assume here, is that any integer between 57 and 200 can act as the mass of an amino acid, right? So we've expanded now our integer mass alphabet from 18 masses to 144 amino acids by making this assumption. So then our question is, okay, we expand our alphabet, and now we have to deal with a larger class of peptides. Let's run our leaderboard cyclopeptide sequencing algorithm on this expanded alphabet to this spectrum 10 with 10% false and missing masses. Now remember, before, when we assumed the standard alphabet, it reconstructed the tyrosidine B1 correctly. But here, when we expand the alphabet out to 144 amino acids, the algorithm now identifies the highest scoring peptide as this peptide, and it incorporates 98 and 65 into the peptide. So it doesn't reconstruct the peptide correctly, and notice that it's brought in two non-standard amino acids. The key point here is that although tyrosidine B1 doesn't actually contain any of these non-standard amino acids, we won't know that when we're doing sequencing experiments. So we need to take them into account. And in this case, the algorithm would tell us that it has non-standard amino acids in it, and that's not good, because it doesn't.